Hi everyone, and thanks for attending our webinar, Building Brand Trust and Increasing Conversions with Visual Commerce.
Hey everyone, I'm Eliza Fisher and I'm so happy to be here with you today. I'm from Los Angeles, where Social Annex is based, and I do email marketing, content, and webinars for us.
And I'm Sarah Foose, Senior Strategist at Demandware on our retail practice team. I work with our clients to help them maximize their usage of our platform, optimize their websites, and develop strategies to grow their overall business. Today, we'll tell you a little bit about Social Annex and Demandware, and then we'll talk about the customer experience that visual commerce should create and how we create it. Then we'll talk about the free visual commerce offering that we're doing, and at the end, we'll answer a few questions. Now I'll hand it off to Eliza.
Hi, everyone. So here's a little bit about us. For the uninitiated, Social Annex makes omnichannel customer loyalty and advocate marketing solutions. Our mission, simply stated, is to turn browsers into buyers, buyers into loyal customers, and loyal customers into advocates who then deliver more shoppers to you. We're headquartered in Los Angeles, and we have offices in the UK and India, and we're growing a lot. Just in March, we added over 20 people to our team, and our applications generate over 2 billion clicks a month. Our six suites of products are login services, customer loyalty, sharing and referrals, user-generated content, visual commerce, and contests. And those six suites of products provide solutions for every step of the customer journey, whether you're looking to increase site traffic, convert more shoppers, retain them, and so on.
Demandware's mission is to meet all the needs of retailers. We're building what we refer to as a unified commerce platform, which we call the Demandware Commerce Cloud. First, what makes the Demandware Commerce Cloud a unified commerce platform is its unified set of capabilities. You can see some of the most important capabilities listed here, broken into three categories: experience, operations, and intelligence. In the experience category, the platform includes merchandising, promotions management, marketing capabilities, content management, and the ability to design and manage digital experiences. In the operations category are product, price, and catalog management, transaction processing, order management, and full point of sale and store operations management capabilities. Finally, in the intelligence category, the platform has built-in retail data model, predictive analytics, which powers intelligent personalization, and descriptive analytics that powers benchmarking and reporting. Also critical to the platform is that these capabilities share a view of key data elements, such as data on each customer, order, product, inventory levels, price, promotion, and interactions. By sharing a view with the Demandware Commerce Cloud, it enables retailers to operate more quickly and freely, treat their customers in a consistent and coordinated fashion across their entire experience. Of course, these are not the only capabilities a retailer is going to need to succeed. Some of these capabilities sit outside the platform in other systems, either from other vendors or homegrown. So the Demandware Commerce Cloud is an open platform, making integration between our platform and these other systems easier than other options, either using pre-built integrations in cases where a third-party vendor is part of our partner network, which Social Annex is, or using our open commerce APIs. The openness of the platform means it's fully customizable, enabling clients to use the platform to build experiences unique to their brand. Finally, the platform is delivered in the cloud entirely. Our cloud is scalable, reliable, and secure, and also features a steady stream of innovative upgrades that are pushed into the platform seamlessly so our clients can use them without disruption. Demandware's Link Technology Partner Ecosystem is a rich set of third-party technology vendors across many categories, some of which you see depicted here, almost all of which have a pre-built integration to the Demandware platform that is certified by Demandware. This makes it much faster and easier for our clients to contract with and deploy these technologies than if they were building custom integrations to a different platform. The Link Technology Partner Ecosystem stands at over 200 carefully vetted partners and is growing. We are proud to have Social Annex as a partner, bringing Demandware clients customer loyalty and advocate marketing solutions like visual commerce, which you'll hear all about today. So with that said, I'll hand it back over to Eliza to talk about images and user-generated content.
Thank you. So the question I want to start out with is, what sort of experiences do images create? Here we have a definition of a plate, a flat dish, typically circular and made of china, from which food is eaten or served. We understand it, but it's a little dull. Here we have visuals. They make a huge difference, right? I'd argue that these colorful images of plates have an effect that's authentic, immediate, and rewarding. If product images at their best fit these three characteristics, I'd say that perhaps we should be striving to make the overall visual commerce experience also more authentic, immediate, and rewarding. So authenticity is a really overused buzzword, but it's apt. When I say an image creates an air of authenticity, I mean it conveys trust and social proof. The viewer feels that he or she is being treated with respect and honesty. In terms of immediacy, I mean a few different things. The human brain processes visual information about 60,000 times faster than it does text. But if our perception of images is immediate, shouldn't our interaction with them be immediate too? Rewarding is maybe the most straightforward term out of the three. Depending on the colors and arrangement in an image, our brains feel calmed or pleased or engaged looking at it. If the image is on your website, this is probably true. I don't know about you, but I felt a sense of happiness looking at all those bright, pretty colors in those photos of plates. It's rewarding to look at a nice image. We should make it rewarding to contribute a quality image too. So let's take a more in-depth look at authenticity. So while influencers are great in a lot of ways, they're usually not real customers. They can provide a sense of authenticity in that they're showing off your product, being worn, and the idea is that this person uses, endorses somehow your products or services. The people who've purchased and believe in your products are always going to be the most authentic advocates for them. You see in this image here, this Instagram user says that her Fry shoes have taken her everywhere. And these types of customers are what we call advocates. Advocates are essentially volunteer marketers, as Jay Baer calls them. They're real customers who love your business and want to talk about it. They refer your friends to your company, write reviews for it, and take and share photos of your products, services, or brand. Even without any incentives, people around the world are taking and sharing pictures and videos of the brands they love. No matter what types of products or services you sell, people are sharing photos. It's their points of view and experiences that make your products authentic through social proof. And when your products are actually being used by your customers, that's when they really come alive. This is just as true as it is for fashion, as it is for food or notebooks, or even ATVs and cars. I love how in this slide, Subaru decided to use advocate marketing to create an emotional appeal with images of customers' dogs in their cars. And it shows just how much context images from advocates can provide and how much they can really shift our perception. But visual commerce doesn't just provide authenticity in this way. One aggregate effect of visual commerce content is that you can give customers views of your products in tons of different contexts. By providing multiple views beyond catalog photos, you show shoppers their functionality and versatility. When we see these sorts of images on product pages, there's a huge difference. It's an extra dimension, really. And clearly this calm, cozy bedroom paints a much more appealing picture of these flameless candles than just the stock photo at the right does. Another vital side of creating an authentic consumer experience through visual commerce is that of permission. Authentic brands treat their customers with respect and only use their content with their consent. So some of you may remember this New York Times article that came out this past fall. It talks about the sticky situation that the shoewear company Crocs created for itself when it used a mother's photo of her child without her permission. Crocs was operating under what are called implicit permissions, which are the idea that when an Instagram user uses a company's hashtag, they're implicitly agreeing to the company's reuse of that photo. It's murky territory at best, and it gets a lot trickier when children are involved, as we'll see in a second. When companies assume implicit permissions, they're only allowed to reuse UGC in their visual commerce on their own websites. And if for whatever reason the original photo is taken off Instagram, it'll just appear as a broken Instagram image on the site because it should only be displayed as a link out to Instagram. So that means that teams have to be on the lookout for these broken links on a daily basis. So in contrast, explicit permissions consist of outright asking a user if he or she agrees to your company reusing a photo. The request appears as a comment on the photo, asking the user to comment back with some iteration of hashtag yes brand. And 70% of the time, users will agree to companies reusing their photos. And when they do this, they can be reused in email marketing, ads, any number of channels. And this can be done with one click in a visual commerce dashboard, which will also have the history of rights requests and permissions documented. And one more piece to add about permissions is that they essentially have to be explicit when it comes to images of children. COPPA, or the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, or about if you sell kids' products, say that businesses need to give direct notice to parents about practices regarding the collection and use of photos and videos, among other things. So the last component of authenticity that we're going to discuss today is personalization. Just like how your business uses advocates, real people, in order to get authentic photos, you should be treating your shoppers as real people too, of course. And real people don't usually like being generically marketed to and want to be treated as individuals with their own tastes and preferences. So I'm going to use a somewhat personal example for this one. I love ASOS. I think they're a very cool retailer whose products and prices fit my wants, and I buy clothing from them all the time. I've been purchasing things from them for at least the past 6 or 7 years, and most of my ASOS purchases are printed dresses and heeled boots. If you look at my order history and saved items, you'll see mainly that. But when I look at ASOS's visual commerce gallery, nothing appears that suits my style. Now, they have a clever fix for this in that they have categories of different styles of clothing, shoes, and accessories. It's great that they have a method of breaking up the beautiful chaos that Instagram feeds can engender and making it more manageable. That said, though, given the amount of data that they have about my personal preferences, it'd be a much more enjoyable experience for me, and I'd be way more likely to buy something via visual commerce if the gallery on their homepage automatically reflected my preferences. And there are a lot of different ways to take the category approach to visual commerce in order to make the content more relevant. For virtually any product, you can do trending product galleries or group images by color, holiday, or season. If you're in cosmetics, you could do makeup mood boards, or if you do cookware or cookbooks, you can sort images by recipe type. Really, any way you can think of to merchandise and categorize your products, you can display in visual commerce. But if we're going beyond the idea of tag categories, we can think about applying website behavior to your displays. For certain shoppers, you might want to display sale items, and for others, you'll want to show off your high margin wares. You can factor in search history, demographic data, including age, and interaction with other UGC even. And if you connect your visual commerce to social login, you can access even more data to further personalize and contextualize your images, like photos and videos from connections or people like the user. And geographic data can be really fruitful too. especially for things like clothing, where there's a very seasonal aspect to it. And one more way to ensure relevance within any categorization of your images is to use a ranking algorithm. Social Annex's version is called SIRA, which is short for Smart Image Ranking Algorithm. It lets you weight different factors such as likes on social, number of followers of the poster, revenue generated, clicks, and so on, in order to optimize the display of your images. That way, whether or not you categorize your images, you'll see the best pictures float to the top. So moving on to the immediate aspect of visual commerce, pictures communicate immediately, as we noted earlier. And if your visual commerce experience isn't essentially immediate, it's not optimized. So your team might be associating hundreds or thousands of pictures a day, and anything that makes that task more convenient is a huge relief. They should be able to do one-click association or associate the same photo to more than one product. Assign it attributes, and so on, all from one place. And on the other side of that, the ability to associate multiple products with one image gives your customers faster access to the products they're interested in purchasing. And so here in this example, there's one photo, and we see that there are two different products from Title IX that are associated. So if I clicked this photo and wanted to learn about the legging, I could. And I would also be introduced to this spotlight. When we're talking about immediacy, we can't avoid the topic of seamless omni-channel shopping. Whichever channel your customers are on, they should be able to immediately see your images and then buy through them. When your audience is on Instagram, you can monetize that channel through Shopic. So when a user is scrolling through his or her Instagram feed, they'll see an image with some item that they like. The user can just go to the business's profile and then tap the link in their bio. And that will take them to a gallery of the business's Instagram images, which they can then tap to get more product details and then tap through to the product page to buy. And for businesses, this is as simple as pasting a link in your Instagram bio. You just upload a photo to Instagram as you normally would, whether it's a catalog photo, branded photo shoot, customer picture, or anything else. And then you just have to log into your dashboard and associate your images, and that's it. They're up on the shoppable mobile gallery without any implementation on your end. And this way, social media teams get the proper credit for delivering shoppers to the site. And your business still has total control over the customer experience. And you can even cultivate immediacy in store. UGC is an easy evergreen source of content for digital displays. Nine West and Lululemon are just two businesses that have used it in this way. Or you could go even further and use touchscreens so shoppers can immediately know what they're looking at and where they can find it, perhaps even within that specific store. And so now we come to the rewarding component of visual commerce. We know that it's rewarding to view these high-quality photos of your advocates, but how can we reward them for contributing? Many, many advocates will share photos without any reward in mind, except for recognition or attention. But in order to really cultivate advocacy at scale, you should consider how you can thank them. So, the simplest way is part of the nature of visual commerce itself. Thank your customers by showing them off. If your customers are logged in socially, you can personalize their site experience so they see themselves alongside the other customers featured on your homepage gallery. I'm not sure if you remember my picture from the beginning of the webinar, but here I am featured with my dog along other shoppers. If you have a loyalty program, it can be really simple to give customers points in exchange for contributing. Olympus Camera is an example of a company that does this very well, and they do a great job of promoting the fact that users will be rewarded for uploading photos to their gallery. Other companies will even just reward customers for using their hashtag on Instagram. And here's a look at some of the amazing photos that Olympus has been able to collect because they've incentivized their fans to share. But even if you don't have a loyalty program, you can reward customers through contests. The skincare line Frank Body, which has seen massive success on Instagram due to their marketing around their coffee skin scrub, has gotten fantastic content by giving products away to select advocates who share their photos. They've also done more elaborate contests, like this one, in which they encourage their audience to make artwork using their products, whether on the packaging or using the scrubs themselves. The winner of the contest got a considerable cash prize, and Frank got tons of unique, beautiful submissions to use for their own marketing efforts. Another contest that gathered some truly striking content was done by a clothing site called Bonadrag. They have an annual holiday wish list contest in which they simply ask their audience to post photos on Instagram of the Bonadrag items that they want with a hashtag. But these customers have gotten really creative. And some, instead of just reposting brand photos or making simple collages of stock images on a white background, have instead made these really memorable and noteworthy collages of their products. They're reflective of Bonadrag's branding and personality, and they're really wonderful for using in other marketing efforts. So in terms of soliciting contributions, you should be doing so with emails, both dedicated and non-dedicated, banners on the site, putting them on cart and checkout pages, as well as on your homepage and product page, displays in the store, reminding shoppers to take photos right then and there, and even on receipts and printouts. This is an example of the company Delia's that puts a package insert in their shipments to remind customers to contribute. And now, in terms of the results we've seen, on average, visual commerce will raise conversion rates by 5 to 7%. It'll increase click-through rates by 15 to 20%. One client found that each photo added an additional $6 of revenue. And another client has seen a 17% conversion rate among visual commerce users. So clearly, visual commerce can really transform your company's success through this resource that customers are actually already creating. You can just help them finesse and optimize it. Okay, so now for the free visual commerce promotion between Social Annex and Demandware. You'll get complete software capabilities for sourcing images from hashtags and manual uploads on your website. You will get full moderation and curation capabilities, as well as rights management, as we discussed earlier. Flexible display capabilities, so you'll have the ability to show your images in a homepage gallery, a homepage slider, sliders on your product pages, and via a dedicated gallery page. Your designs will also all be mobile responsive, and you'll get your dashboard with comprehensive reporting capabilities. And then in terms of managed services, you will get the requirements definition and provided wireframes from us, customization based on your design with our wireframes, the setup of the data feed integration, admin reporting and training, Demandware cartridge integration, of course, and initial support during the launch on your site.
Great, thank you, Eliza. Let's wrap up the webinar with some questions. First question for you. If I implement the visual commerce solution on my website, what type of behind the scenes information will I have access to?
So you'll always see a curation trail, as well as statistics about your return on investment, submission sources, that is, which social networks your photos are coming from, or if you're enabling manual upload on your site or upload through Facebook on your site, those as well as device usage. And then if your visual commerce is integrated with something like social login or loyalty, you'll be able to track engagement and submissions as they relate to the data that you get from those products too. And that way you can get a better understanding of who's contributing to your gallery.
Great. What are all the sources I can get images from when using visual commerce? And if I get a lot of images, what's the best way to organize and keep track of them all?
So in terms of automatically pulling images from hashtags, you can do this through Instagram and Twitter. Unfortunately, Facebook and Snapchat don't allow for this, but there are various types of manual upload that you can do on your site. So users can upload photos and videos from their desktops, phones, or any other storage device, where they can upload a photo through Facebook on your site. And then in terms of organizing and keeping track of them, we discussed part of that earlier when talking about your product association capabilities. And you can also create customer reports for your teams in order to, if you say have a merchandising team for home goods and then a merchandising team for clothing within one store, you can make sure that those teams are seeing the images that they need to see. So you can create the specialized reporting and viewing capabilities.
Okay, and then what is the typical time commitment for brands in terms of curating online galleries? Specifically, what advice can you give to brands with limited headcount?
So the typical time commitment will vary a lot depending on, you know, how big your company is, whether you sell a very limited range of products or whether you sell, you know, tens of thousands of products. But for teams with a limited headcount or who feel too overwhelmed by all the photos they're getting, Socialenics does offer curation on our end. So we can set clients up with their own curation team, full-time dedicated just to them, in order to streamline that process. So your team only needs to worry about the bigger picture issues.
That's great. Okay, it looks like that wraps up our questions for today. Thank you all for joining us for our webinar.
Thank you so much.